Hello guys, I'm Dr. Sarabjit Singh. Today I'll be showing you a video of using RS hooks in a case of small pupil. In this particular case, it was a case of sclerosia pupillae, and there were a lot of posterior sinicae which I had to break and then use the RS hooks. So I'll be showing you this video, but then this is an old video which I did maybe about 7, 8, 9 years ago. After that, I've changed my method of using RS hooks. I will later on, after the video, after the surgery video, I shall be showing you an illustration of what I mean by changed, what kind of configuration I do now. I just couldn't find one of my videos where I could show you the new configuration, but I'll try to explain it through an illustration. So, okay, let's watch the video now. So here I'm making a paracentesis for both the RS hooks as well as for the side ports. You see that there are a lot of PS. I use my cystotome to actually break the sinicae. You can use a Sinsky hook or a Y hook, which are probably a bit safer to use. Once I'm positive that I've broken all the sinicae, I start putting in the RS hooks one by one. Initially, I don't tighten them much, maybe halfway. And then after the last one, then you start to tighten them to make the pupil bigger. Then I inject the viscoelastic and do the capsulorhexis. From here on, it's quite a routine case, but there are a couple of things which we have to keep in mind. One is that when you do the paracentesis for the RS hooks, please do them maybe about 2 millimeters away from the limbus. If it is too close to the limbus, it's going to pull the iris forward and your anterior chamber is going to become shallow. That is one thing which we must keep in mind. In this case, I'm using my old Millennium Phaco machine, which I really loved. That was a superb machine, but of course now it's not available, out of service. And then I'm doing the irrigation aspiration here. Those days I used to change my filter to yellow filter, hoping that this would be a bit of help to the retina and kinder to the retina. So the capsule is very clear, and I inject, in this case, I think one of the Zeiss models of IOLs. So once the IOL goes in, you remove the RS hooks, do the irrigation aspiration, and then you hydrate the cornea to make it watertight. So the thing is, this is the conventional method which we use. Pardon my not so good drawing, but I'll try to explain to you. This is what I did. So these are the RS hooks which have gone in, and that this is the square configuration of the pupil now. So between two RS hooks, that's where I made my incision for my phaco tip entry. But the problem here is that the excursion of the needle is from side to side, one side of the square to the other. And the second problem is the fluid from the irrigation ports can go behind the iris. The iris can balloon up and also it can be pulled into the phaco tip. So these are a few problems which you might encounter with this method. An easier method would be just rotate your iris hook configuration by 45 degrees. So now the iris hooks are about 45 degrees anti-clockwise. And the iris hooks are placed, and this time the configuration looks like a diamond. So your phaco tip goes over one of the iris hooks. Now in this case the excursion is from one apex to the other, one angle to the other, which is more, and then the iris is actually pinning down, the iris hook is pinning down the iris, so there is no chance of iris getting stuck into the port, the phaco tip. So this is the diamond configuration, and I find this is much easier to use. When I find my older video, I shall share it with you, or maybe next time I'll do this method and share it with you. I hope it helps. Thank you very much for watching. See you later. Please do subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Bye bye.